Hey, what's up, studs? Ryan here, or M&R Productions, and today we're taking a look at all four LEGO AATs, or Armored Assault Tanks, from 2000, 2009, 2015, and 2020, respectively. So quite a range of years there. LEGO has changed a lot in the 20 years since we got our first AAT, but has it changed in a bad way? Well, there's only one way to find out, and that's to take an in-depth look at all of these AATs side by side.
Go through my comparison system with minifigures, playability, design, value, and M&R opinion, leading to a final score to help us see which AATs are better and in which aspects, because I think that's pretty interesting too. But before we go through all that, we have to go over some basic information about each AAT. This is set number 7155 from the year 2000, based off episode 1, The Phantom Menace. It retailed for $20 when it was released, and adjusted for inflation, that's about $30 in 2020 money. It included 158 pieces and those two figs there. This is set 8018 from 2009, based off Star Wars The Clone Wars. It retailed for $50 when originally released, adjusted for inflation, that's about $60, and included 407 pieces. It had seven figures. 2015's offering was set number 75080, retailing for $25, adjusted for inflation $27, with 251 pieces and three minifigures. And finally, the newest model in this comparison video, set 75283 from the year 2020, retailing for $40, no inflation adjustment because it's still the same year it was released, 286 pieces in the set, and four figures shown in front. Starting off with the first AAT from the year 2000, you literally just got a couple of regular battle droids, and they had these really weird large megaphone weapons that really didn't do well with the battle droids because the battle droids are already very light, and then those weapons are very heavy, and so they would fall over if you tried to use them. Not very ideal. 2009, I liken to your grandma spoiling you on Christmas or on your birthday and just giving you way too many gifts, and then it kind of makes everything else pale in comparison. That's what 2009 was like for the AAT. You got two regular battle droids, which already matched what you got the prior version. You got three super battle droids with rocket arms. That's freaking amazing. And then to top it all off, a clone trooper from the Clone Wars and a Clone Wars version of Yoda. It's hard to look at it and not think that it's the best, but moving on to 2015, they came in with a battle droid pilot, a regular battle droid, and Jar Jar Binks. So you get one named character, I guess, a couple battle droids, but still, you look back to the years prior, no, maybe not 2000, but 2009, and there's just no comparison between those two sets of characters there. Moving into the most recent version, though, from 2020, there were a couple of formerly known Kashyyyk battle droids, but they're actually AAT pilot droids, which is great. That's actually very accurate to what the AAT has inside of it, so that's a big plus to 2020. You got the 332nd Trooper, and then, of course, Ahsoka Tano from Season 7 of The Clone Wars. Great figure selection as well, and that is your four minifig selections for the AAT. There are some very large differences that we see over the years. Ultimately, to me, the best figure selection has got to go to 2009. There's just so much there for the price. I feel like that is the best, so that's going to get the full 4 points. Receiving 3 points for this category is going to be 2020 here. The pilot droids are wonderful. They are very accurate to the AAT, and obviously Ahsoka and her clone are great and a big draw for that set, actually, for a lot of people. Receiving 2 points will be the Jar Jar Droid Alliance there for 2015, and as the worst AAT figure selection, 2000. Just a couple of battle droids. Everyone else has at least a couple of battle droids. Let's talk playability. Each set has its own unique feature set, and I think that there is definitely something for everyone here as far as playability versus displayability goes. We're going to get into the display of it in a moment, and the design and everything. That's the next category. But as far as play features go, let's start out with the year 2000 and see what it had to offer. The set from 2000 did not have a lot. Flickfire missiles didn't exist. Spring-loaded shooters didn't exist. So you get the point. No stud shooters either. Like, 2000 was a very different time. So there is no functioning, firing anything on this set. All these cannons are just for show. You have this small area at the front here, which you can fit a battle droid into, if you even want to call that a play feature, but he fits in there. And none of these cannons, like, spin or anything. If you pull on them, they're going to fall off. Like, there's no movement to that. I guess these antennas move, but that's just because they're antennas, and that really doesn't do much for me personally. This cannon on the top does have a great range of motion, though. That is basically the main play feature of it, is just pretending like it's shooting things, and you can have the cannon point up, but at some point
These got really brittle and hard to move, so it is tough to get it to orient in any way. And even at that, you're very much limited to the positions that that Technic piece allows you to have on that cannon, which is kind of a bummer. Definitely not the best thing. The other play feature in the back here is also riddled with the same issue. You can see they use those same Technic pieces, and what's going to happen here is I'm going to try to pull this up. It's just going to pop off, probably. Yep. But I guess that's not the terrible thing. Like, you can pop it off and then put the battle droid in and then put it back on, but drop him in there, put his head down, and there you go, ready to go back into battle with the droids inside. I don't really consider putting droids inside like that, like a play feature, and I think all of these sets really will replicate the same thing as far as that goes. There's also a nice area to place your droids' weapons here on either side of the AAT, just like that, fits right in. But yeah, that's really all the 2000 model has to offer in terms of play. And that to me is just not very exciting. If we bring in 2009 here, you're looking at a much, much different package. For starters here, we'll just start up at the cannon. The cannon moves so much easier, so much more precise cannon in that way. It can also spin probably about the same like range of motion there. You can probably move the things blocking it from spinning 360 degrees, but they have pieces on here to block it from doing that. The top of the cannon has another hatch, just like the other one. You can open it up and place a battle droid inside. In this case, I just got him bent down so that he'll fit right in. Drop that on top, just like the other one. Now, in this particular AAT's case, this can open up here at the front and you can actually drop a battle droid inside, but it's actually going to be way easier to do it like this because it's the most accurate in this way too, that you can kind of drop this panel down in the back, much like it does in the Clone Wars. It's a little hard to reach at sometimes, but eventually you can get it dropped down. But it's really not a panel, it's actually an entire little speeder that they have included, a little transport speeder. So you can take a battle droid and push him on in there and have him hold on to the handlebars, and he is going to be good to go and ride that around and also be like the co-pilot or the gunner on the inside of the AAT, which is great. So you can see how when it's going to be in there and folded up, he's going to be fine. Versus when he's not in there and driving around, it's also fine. It's got no inverted tiles on the bottom though. I guess that's not a big deal, but yeah, that's gonna clip right in there. Nice, very nice play feature. Probably the best one out of any of the AATs with that particular feature. And then on the side, you actually have like fire missiles. So you can just push them out if you want like this, and it's gonna be rather lame. Not actually as bad as you may imagine. And these cannons also do have a range of motion, so you can flip them up and have them shoot into the sky. You can have them shoot behind you. Like, they definitely have a great thing going there with these particular cannons on this set. Again, the cannons in the old set didn't move, so that was a big negative. On the bottom, you'll find the inverted tiles, which allow for easier movement over like hard surfaces like this wooden table. The year 2015 brought much of the same. You have a hatch on top, which you can place a minifigure in. I'm not gonna even bother doing it every time around here at this point. You can place another minifigure into this center hatch, which is pretty tight in there. I would say even tighter than the year 2000's model, but still nice to have both those features incorporated into the build. The cannons on the side have no movement. There's no flick fire missile. Like, there's nothing going on there. But the one feature that this set did bring to the table that neither of the two previous versions had is spring-loaded shooters. And you found these right up underneath the set. You can see some of the inverted tiles just like on the other sets. And you have these little pieces at the back here to shoot them off like this, and they shoot off pretty great. Like, great little feature that LEGO came up with in 2014, so it's nice that they're so easily incorporated into the front. The latest model brings much of the same. You have a cannon which can move up and down. You have a hatch you can open and place a character into, no big deal. The front also does have a hatch and a actually rather spacious and detailed area with control panels and everything for one of your AAT pilot droids to go ahead and sit down in there and make use of that space. The cannons on the side actually do move in this case, and this one, much like the 2015 version, has those spring-loaded shooters. You can see them at the front here peeking out, and you can see this. I like the mechanism on this more. I think it works more consistently, but you're going to push back and down on this particular piece here, and I'll shoot out right into my hand here in this case, like that. So you can see that's going to work way better than the one from 2015. I've had some problems with the 2015 play feature in that way, so this one definitely improves upon that. Let's take a look at the final results for playability though. Playability to me is going to go much like the minifigure category, with the 2009 AAT taking the cake. It's just so good, especially with that little transport speeder built into the back. With 3 points here, the 2020 AAT, I know I've said a lot of bad things about it, but it's undeniable that it does pack a punch as far as play features go. 2015, pretty good, but the lack of movement on the side cannons is extremely disappointing. And then 2000 is just a real rough time. No flickable, fireable missiles or anything like that. The cannons on the side don't move. The antennas don't count. Let's not have that argument. And then really all you can do is just place minifigs inside. Like, that's pretty much the extent of the feature on that one, other than the cannon moving. So definitely a little bit disappointing there. Still like the model, but playability-wise is what we're talking about. Not that great. So that is what we're looking at heading into the design and display aspect of things here.
I think it's been very interesting to watch LEGO over 2 decades change the design of the AAT so much. They went from such a rudimentary design to one so clean and elegant in 2009, and then they really downsized it in 2015 and 2020. They kind of stuck with the same sizing. And I think that the side profile shot kind of tells it all. Like, you really do see a lot here, and it's really telling what they've done with the newest model that I think is really bad, and that's that cannon. The cannon is just ridiculously long, and compared to the realistic version of the AAT in universe, it's not even close, and people are making excuses for it too. It's kind of funny to watch the internet do this of like, oh, kids don't care. It's like, I don't care if kids don't care. That's not the point. The point is, they had 3 great renditions of the AAT that were all relatively accurate, right? Everything's going to vary some degree, but then you get this monstrosity with this cannon, like it's taken cannon enlargement pills, and it doesn't make any sense. So unless both I and LEGO designers have looked at the completely wrong reference photos of AATs for the last 20 years, I don't know where this came from, and it's really, really sad for me to see.
The UFO saucers of 2000 were a very interesting and unique piece that really gave that 2000 AAT such a unique and, in my opinion, accurate look. Like, it really has that, like, look of just sleekness to it, where the whole back section of the AAT kind of rides behind the front hood, and it looks really cool for that. I really enjoy that. Obviously, some of the design is outdated now and doesn't look great, but overall, I really love the look of this AAT so much that I actually own 2. One small negative about this 2000 set's design, though, real quick, is on the backside, you just see a lot of exposed blue pieces. This was something pretty common for LEGO in the early 2000s, so I don't really make it a real knock against the set. It's kind of nostalgic for some people, but it definitely is not accurate, like, at all. 2009, of course, probably going to be the king here. I don't even want to talk about it that much, but it's huge. I love the size of it just compared to the other ones. Obviously, that comes with the higher price tag than any of the other ones, but it definitely looks wonderful. It has a great integration of studs while still looking tiled off in a lot of areas. And then I think maybe its biggest downfall is its use of stickers, especially those clear stickers that get the bubbles and everything over time, or maybe when I put them on. They just don't look great. I think that's fair to say, is that those stickers don't look great. But overall, that design of the 2009 AAT is just so dang good. And I think a lot of people, it's like the consensus best AAT. 2015 brought us something different. It received a lot of flack at the time, actually, for its design, but kind of looking back on it, it's not as bad now. And I have a negative thing to say about this one. I know a lot of people don't like it already, but with the cannon can spin all the way around, which is probably actually good, but the cannon can look down. None of the other AAT cannons can look down. This does not look good, but it does look good when it's like pointed like slightly down at maybe someone that's standing really close to it. But the negative really comes when you want to lift the cannon up, and really you're not going to lift the cannon up much farther than that realistically, but if you actually do keep lifting the cannon up, it pushes back on this and lifts the whole thing up, and then obviously it doesn't come down with it, and it looks kind of weird. So definitely not a great aspect of the design there.
The cannon looks a little bit funky, or the whole like top section looks a little bit funky, but not as funky as 2020, because this looks too skinny, but this looks way too wide for the body, and obviously the cannon way too long. I think another thing the 2020 AAT gets wrong that is kind of underlooked here is that its little side cannons are flipped. They have the smaller cannon on top and the larger cannon on the bottom. As far as I can tell from every reference photo I've looked at, the larger cannon goes on top here and the smaller cannon goes on the bottom. And I checked the box, I checked the instruction, I didn't build it wrong. That is how they have it built. Oh, but you can mod it. I don't care that you can mod it. That's not what matters. What matters is what the designers put out, and this is what they put out. And I just
I can't wrap my head around a lot of it like that. There's also supposed to be a blue stripe that runs up the center of the AAT. You'll see that this is present in 2009, just completely absent in this newer model. And then there's also supposed to be a blue stripe basically running the backside of this on the other side of the gray. Again, present on 2009, not present on 2020.
I did enjoy the building techniques of the 2020 model, though. I think that those engines are really solid, and I loved building those. And nothing's really going to fall off on the model otherwise. It's just a really solid build, other than the fact that it's pretty inaccurate. I think that's the fairest thing to say about it. 2015 was pretty good, as well as the build being solid. Like, 2009, pretty solid. Like, all these AATs are pretty solid builds. It just comes down to the accuracy and a lot in personal preference as far as the way you like your AAT to look. Personally, I just don't like having a cannon that goes, like, 6 inches farther off than it's supposed to be. The cannon is supposed to end at the front of the hood. It's been a huge complaint I've had about this newer AAT, and I think a lot of people have had, but it's been funny watching other people defend it, even though it's just blatantly wrong. So the set with the best design is absolutely the 2009 set. I'm giving it 4 points here. The set, in my opinion, with the second best design is 2000. I really love the look of this puppy here. I don't know what it is. It's got such a classic look, but still looks so good for what it is. Like, I really, really like that 2000 design. I think a lot of people might have this as their favorite AAT, even over the 2009 model, but personally, it's my second favorite design. The third best design absolutely has to go to 2015, and it's going to get 2 points, and I should be allowed to award 0 points to 2020 because I feel like it didn't even try, but I don't think I've ever done that, so I don't think I'm going to start doing that here. I'll give it the 1 point. It gets the participation ribbon here, but ultimately it just fails to hit a lot of the marks that AATs should be accurate to. And as far as display goes, I mean, I guess technically you can put any of these on the shelf all the same, but the 2000 is just going to get that nostalgic draw, and the 2009 is just going to get that, oh my god, that's a big AAT draw. The other two just don't really hit the mark there. So which AAT provided the best value? Well, we're quickly going to have to go back over the prices adjusted for the inflation to kind of better understand that. Looking at $30, $60, $27, and $40 respectively. I think ultimately the 2009 model has to provide the best value and is going to get the full credit for that one. I think my answer for second best value, though, may surprise a lot of people, and that's going to go to the 2020 AAT right there. I think the minifigures really, really provide a lot in the way of value for that set. And unlike the other sets, they do have like actual printed battle droids. Technically, the AAT pilot droid is printed, but these are like actual like detailed prints on the heads and everything, and accurate to what you want to see there. And then, of course, Ahsoka and the 332nd Trooper are going to be huge draws and get a lot of people to buy this set. So I think in that way, this set does provide decent value. Obviously, not very accurate, but good value. The 2000 model going to come in at number 3 here and get 2 points. And then the worst value to me was 2015. Just comparatively, you end up with a really small model, only a few figures. Everyone else, I think, has better figure selection except 2000, but the bigger, better model, in my opinion, than 2015. So overall, we're looking at 4, 3, 2, and 1 point for the value category. So on the whole, which AAT set do I think is best? This is the M&R opinion category. I'm going to get it out of the way. 2009, to me, is easily the best AAT there has ever and probably will ever be. I just can't get my head around them ever making anything better than that, especially after seeing what they did for 2020 here. So it's going to get the full 4 points, and it's really going to ace this test because it's gotten the full 4 points in all the other categories. So 2009 AAT, in my opinion, is just easily the best. For me, the second best AAT is 2000. I love that model. It's just the nostalgia there, I think, that really gets me, and it's going to get 3 points. Now, where I think my opinion gets really interesting is for these two AATs. I think that this AAT build is just objectively terrible. It looks really, really inaccurate to what you see. But the 2015 model isn't like way too much better that it's like, oh my god, yeah, that is definitely like, you know, a mile better. I think it's more accurate in a lot of ways, like the length of the barrel and everything cutting off where it's supposed to. But the figure selection of the newer AAT, I think, is enough to draw me out of that tiebreaker there. I really love the 332nd and Ahsoka, and I think that that's what breaks the tie. I still think that that AAT is really bad. I do. I think it's the worst AAT build they've ever done as far as like the actual accuracy, but I don't think I can say that overall it's not a better set
than 2015. So my opinion is that this gets 2 points and this gets 1 point.
This is typically the point in the video where I would inquire you to vote on the poll on the top right, and you would vote for which AAT you think is best, and then everyone could see the results. Unfortunately, YouTube took that feature away, so I actually ran a poll on my community tab, and I'm going to be doing this for all future comparisons going forward. And the results went as follows. 3% of the votes went to the 2000 AAT, and this is with a sample size of about 6,000. Hopefully I'll get a greater sample size in the future, but I only ran the poll for about an hour before filming this. So 3% of people voted for the 2000 AAT. 62% of people, the majority, voted for the 2009 set as the best AAT. 7%, surprisingly to me, more than the 2000 set, 7% voted for the 2015 set, and 29% of people, maybe some recency bias there, maybe some Ahsoka bias, but 29% of people did vote for the 2020 AAT as their favorite, or what they think is the best AAT set to date. So that's what you guys, the fans, had to say about these sets. Thank you for your votes. So interestingly enough, despite how much I trashed on the 2020 AAT, it still came in second place with 11 points, which is surprising, I think. You know, it has good figures, it has decent value, it ends up just a little bit better than the 2015 one, in my opinion, because of the minifigures, like a lot of things like that play in. It has good playability, it's just so inaccurate, so it got 1 point. It like definitely lost the accuracy category, but it did decently in the other categories. So I think that that's why that set ended up a little bit higher than you may have thought as far as this particular comparison video goes. First place with a full 16 points was 2009, second place with 9 points was 2000, and last place with 8 points was 2015. Overall, I would recommend them more in my opinionated order, less the like more slightly scientific order of scoring there. I find the results to be very different than what I would have expected going into this, but that is the results of the comparison. That's the numbers we came up with. So let me know your opinion on these in the comments section below. If you enjoyed the comparison, a like is greatly appreciated, and you can actually check out more comparisons with the playlist link in the description and on the end screen now. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.